On the Knocking at the Gate in Macbeth is an essay written by Thomas Dark Vincey. In this essay, the writer talks about what impressions this particular scene from Macbeth has on him and what are all its psychological implications on the reader. Thomas Dark Vincey is an English essayist and critic. He comes from a very rich family background, but because of his addiction to opium, has lost so much in his life, and his best known work is Confessions of an English Opium Eater. In Act 2, Scene 3 is where you find the knocking at the gate scene in the tragedy of Macbeth, written by Shakespeare. In this scene, King Duncan is murdered by Macbeth and Lady Macbeth. Soon after they kill the king, they hear a knock at the gate of the castle. So, Dark Vincey is more intrigued about the knocking at the gate than the killing. So he registers his reflections upon this particular scene in this essay. There are two things in particular which made Dark Vincey write about this particular scene. One is the murder itself, because it is an immense heinous crime, because the murdered man is a king. Second, Dark Vincey is bought by the stagecraft employed by Shakespeare here. Now, he talks about the eerie feeling which the audience is able to sense after the murder of the king. And Dark Vincey is personally obsessed about the magicality of this scene, wherein he is able to find a shift between two states of mind. Now, Dark Vincey also studies a murder which happened in 1812 by an infamous man called Williams. It is called the Ratcliffe Highway Murders, where you find the murderer William. He hides inside a house. And he has already killed the house owner by name Mar, and he has killed Mar's wife, his apprentice boy, and even the infant in the house. Soon after killing all these people, he hears a knock at the door, where the servant girl returns from one of her shows, Dark Vincey, and he's more interested in studying the passion behind the act. He's worried about what makes the murderer commit this crime, and he shifts the sympathies from the victim to the murderer. Naturally, when a murder happens, all concerns will be about the murdered man. Nobody will pay attention to why the crime actually happened. And Dark Vincey rightly feels that the behind the murder also is more important. He talks about heightened emotions like jealousy, ambition, vengeance, hatred. It could be any one of these things that could be the passion behind the act. And then he narrows down to the question of why did Macbeth kill Duncan? The reason is more important than the act. But the reason why Macbeth killed Duncan is because he was overambitious. Vaulting ambition becomes Macbeth's downfall. And he is triggered by his wife also. Together, in a fit of anger, he plans this murder and he commits this murder. Dark Vincey then explains about how knocking is used as a symbol in the play. Here he talks about the contradicting nature of human beings, and he uses the law of antagonism here, which talks about how two things inside a man consistently work against one another. So, human beings are placed between the human nature and the fiendish nature. Though there are a lot of differences between these two natures, man is caught between these two strong emotions. And when a man becomes evil, he is depleted of the divine nature of love and mercy which is granted to him. In Macbeth, knocking thus becomes a symbol. Knocking brings back the character to his senses, and it helps him snap back into consciousness. And Da Quincy compares this situation to two things. One, he says that this can be equated to a person's relief he feels after a fainting wife or a sister comes back to normalcy. Or the same thing can be equated to a woman when the city gets back to normalcy after mourning a celebrated hero for a very long time. Knocking marks the retiring of the human heart and entry of the fiendish heart here. The murderers thus lose their human dimensions, and you find Lady Macbeth is unsexed, and along with Macbeth, she enters the world of devils. To highlight this transition from the ordinary world into the new world, the strange world of the devils, the act of knocking is used in the play. So, this in a greater way suggests the returning to the normal world in a great way, accentuates the whole scene. It creates an acute feeling of the horror of this violent crime which is done. So, knocking thus has a lot of magical quality in this particular scene, and Da Quincy calls this a psychological criticism. And he gives a lot of importance to what goes in Macbeth's mind and Lady Macbeth's mind, rather than the act of murder itself. So these are the few important things that you find in this essay.